tonight, 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 I'm all yours. You know, you know, you know the hold you got on my heart is so pure. And I know sometimes, 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 sometimes you have to note this doubt in your mind.
Thanks for watching. So I just got back from a vacation and I decided to do this video because oftentimes I hear people say that it's quite difficult to get work done or study during a vacation, and I was one of those people actually, until I realized that my due date's coming up and I have to focus. Anyways, I took a vacation during Songkran break, aka the water festival in Thailand, and I came up with 4 tips on how to balance work and fun during vacation time. Although I have to point out one thing, I understand that people's definition of fun can vary. So if you are the type of person who enjoys, you know, drinking till late or partying with friends, going to the club, waking up late, then I don't think you'll be able to relate. But if you define fun by lazing about on the beach, swimming in the pool or the ocean, walking along the beach, eating a lot of food, working out here or there, or going shopping in the evenings, or having a chill type dinner with family, friends, then you might be able to relate. I also realize these tips are quite obvious to some, but anyways, I enjoyed filming it and editing the video too much not to upload it, so I hope you like it and stay tuned for my tips. By the way, today's a Friday, so happy weekend everyone. And to my Thai friends, happy Songkran.
Tip number 1, print out your most important documents to read. I printed out 2-3 reports that I had to read up on. I didn't want to print out too many because these reports can go over 100 pages. Also, having a hard copy to read makes it easier to carry around from the beach to the pool to the restaurant without hassling on the setup and battery life. You can also add notes, circle important facts, or underline with marker all the necessary and vital piece of information required. Later, I just skim to the important parts and transfer that to my laptop file. In this case, I didn't have to carry around my laptop and worry about having accidents, because accidents do happen, and if you're like me, your laptop is your entire life's work. Tip number 2, have a schedule. If you already know the amount of time you're taking off, then schedule your days properly. Break it down per day and follow that plan. In my case, I plan from 7 a.m. all the way to 10:30 p.m. So I wake up at 7 a.m. and start to get ready. I wash my face, brush my teeth, and put cream on. By 7:30, I'll head to a buffet and get some breakfast. I like eggs, bacon, French toast, and salad. And of course, my dose of coffee and pineapple shake. By 9 a.m., I'll head to the hotel's gym for a 1-hour low-intensity workout session. Afterwards, I'll head back to the room to prep my swimming suit, sunscreen lotion, and my bag to go down to the beach. By 11, I'll have set myself up to study for at least 2 hours straight. There's just nothing more relaxing than studying by the beach while soaking up some vitamin D's. Also, don't forget to have a water bottle within reach. By 1 p.m., I'll head to the restaurant and start a quick study session, just go over some notes while waiting for my meal. Finally, it arrives at 1:15. At 2, I'd head down to the beach after changing into a dry swimming suit and continue my studying. On the first 2 days, I'll have dinner at 6 by the beach to watch the beautiful sunset. At 8, I'll return to the gym for a 1 hour workout session, and by 9:30, after having my nighttime routine, brushing my teeth, showering, and prepping myself on the bed, I'll start studying from 9:30 to 10:30. Usually afterwards, I fall asleep. The next day, I'll just repeat this entire routine with a few changes here and there. Tip number 3. Make use of hotel resources. Usually hotels will have either a library room and or an internet area for guests to use. I definitely took advantage of that, mostly because nobody seemed to be using it at all. The room was so quiet, there was air conditioning and a very large desktop screen, which I absolutely love. Also, the Wi-Fi in my room was not connecting to my laptop, so going to the library and using the super fast internet was necessary for me to do my work. Tip number 4, talk to someone about your topic of study. If you're traveling with friends or family or a partner, just casually bring it up in conversations, maybe explain to them what you're doing or studying, and see how well they understand it. As Einstein puts it, if you can't explain it simply, you don't understand it well enough. This is a great practice to see how your topic will be viewed from the general audience. But don't bombard whoever you're with by constantly just bringing up your thesis, because that would just be rude and inconsiderate to them. During a vacation, there should be a sense of balance between work and play. Thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe.